I'm Jerry Ho, ASO Associate Conductor and Music Director of the Atlanta Symphony Youth Orchestra. Earlier this summer, hundreds of students from all across of Metro Atlanta auditioned for the Youth Orchestra. In September, we welcomed 116 of these incredibly talented musicians to Symphony Hall to experience the joy of creating classical music with their peers, providing them with the opportunity to hone their skills and make lifelong memories. Throughout the season, students will participate in master classes, rehearsals, and perform three full-length concerts. Today, we would like to share the first of these concerts with you. Each musician and their family has put in dozens of hours to make this performance possible, from practicing their part, to studying recordings, to traveling to rehearsals, some driving from as far as Columbus, Georgia. Thank you for making all of this possible. Without further ado, it brings me great pleasure to present to you the Atlanta Symphony Youth Orchestra's 2021 Overture Concert.
Thank you. Thank you.
That piece you just heard was Amen by Carlos Simon. Carlos is a composer from Atlanta, and this piece was supposed to represent a service at a Pentecostal church. Now we will journey across the Atlantic to Fair Verona for excerpts from Prokofiev's Romeo and Juliet. Joining us for this performance will be members of the teen ensemble from Alliance Theater.
Two households, both alike in dignity. In fair Verona, where we lay our scene. From ancient grudge, break to new mutiny. Where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a pair of star-crossed lovers take their life, whose misadventured piteous overthrows do with their death bury their parent strife. The fearful passage of their death marked love, and the continuance of their parents' rage, which but their children's end not could remove, is now the 2 hours' traffic of our stage. The which, if you with patient ears attend, what here shall miss, our toil shall strive to mend.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, but soft! What light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill the grievous moon that is already sick and pale with grief, that thou, her maid, art far more fair than she. It is my lady. Oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew she were. She speaks, yet says nothing. What of that? Her eye discourses. I will answer it. I am too bold. Okay. Tis not to me she speaks to. Two of the fairest stars in all the heaven, having some business, do entreat her eyes to twinkle in their spears till they return. What if they were there, they in her head? See how she leans her cheek upon that hand? Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek.
Holy Saint Francis, what a change is here. Is Rosaline, whom thou didst love so dear, so soon forsaken? Ah, young men's love then lies, not truly in their hearts, but in their eyes. Jesu Maria, what a dill of brine hath washed thy sallow cheeks. For Rosaline, how much salt water thrown away in waste, to season love that of it doth not taste. The sun not yet thy sighs from heaven clears. Oh, thy old groans ring yet in my ancient ears. Lo, here upon thy cheek the stain doth sit of an old tear that is not yet washed. If e'er thou wast thyself and these woes thine, thou and these woes were all for Rosaline. And art thou changed? Pronounce this sentence then. Women may fall when there is no strength in men.
Thank you. Farewell. God knows when we will meet again. I have a faint, cold fear thrills through my veins that almost freezes up the heat of life. I'll call them back again to comfort me. Nurse! But what should she do here? My dismal scene, I needs must act alone. Come, Vile. What if this mixture do not work at all? Shall I be married then tomorrow morning? No! 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 This will forbid it. Lie thou there. What if be a poison which the friar hath ministered to have me dead, lest he be dishonored in his marriage, because he married me before to Romeo, I fear it is. And yet, methinks it should not, because he hath still been tried a holy man. How, if when I am being laid into the tomb, I wake before the time Romeo come to redeem me? There's a fearful point. Shall I not then be stifled in that vault to whose foul mouth no healthsome air breathes, and there die, strangled ere my Romeo come? Or, if I live, is it not very like the horrible conceit of death and night, together with the terror of the place where for these many hundred years the bones of all my buried ancestors are packed, where bloody Tybalt, yet but green in the earth, lies festering in his shroud, where, as some say, at some hours of the night, spirits resort. Oh, if I live, shall I not be distraught and fired by all these hideous fears, and in this rage, with some great kinsman's bone, madly dash out my desperate brains? Oh, look! Methinks I see my cousin's ghost seeking out Romeo, who did spit him upon a rapier's point. Stay, Tybalt, stay. Romeo, I come. This do I drink to thee.
Thank you.
That was Mark Gresham's The Embrace, written in 1996 for the ASYO to celebrate the Olympics here in Atlanta. Our musical journey will now return to Italy with Respighi's The Pines of Rome, a beautiful symphonic poem celebrating the nature of the Eternal City.
Thank you. Thank you.